Hello everyone, welcome to pfox.com. This is Arun Moturi. In this Selenium automation tutorial series, I am going to continue with the topic FireBug and FirePath alternatives. In this current video session, I am going to cover the third part of this FireBug and FirePath alternatives topic, that is ChroPath for Chrome browser. How to install and use ChroPath in Chrome browser. That is the context of this current video session. So guys, let's get started. So ChroPath for Chrome browser. So we used to have legendary add-ons like FireBug and FirePath. Okay. Now they are not available, guys. Okay. They got deprecated and discontinued. So for this problem of FireBug and FirePath deprecation, there we got good number of add-ons, guys. Okay, we got good number of add-ons, list of add-ons we got as an alternative for using FireBug and FirePath, which got deprecated and no longer available now. Okay, so one of the alternatives we have is the ChroPath, guys, and you can have this ChroPath in Chrome browser, in Firefox browser, in Opera browser also, but I recommend using ChroPath add-on in Chrome browser. This is the best alternative, guys, for the problem of FireBug and FirePath deprecation problem. ChroPath add-on in Chrome browser is the best alternative out of all the other alternatives. Okay, out of all the other alternatives that I already explained in the previous video. Okay, ChroPath add-on in Chrome browser, that too in the Chrome browser, is the best alternative for the deprecated FireBug and FirePath add-ons. So in place of FireBug and FirePath add-ons which got deprecated, if we use ChroPath add-on in Chrome browser, that is going to be the best alternative. I recommend using ChroPath in Chrome browser, guys. Though you can have ChroPath in Firefox and Opera, I personally recommend you to use ChroPath add-on in Chrome browser. Okay. So coming to the deprecation of FireBug and FirePath, I already covered in the previous videos. At same time, I already covered the list of different alternatives we have for this FireBug and FirePath add-ons. Okay, in the previous video itself. Okay, so if you have not gone there, just go back to the previous videos and go through them and come back here, guys. Okay, for now, in this current video session, I am going to explain how to install ChroPath in Chrome browser, then how to auto generate the XPath expressions and CSS selectors using this ChroPath add-on in Chrome browser. Then finally, I am going to explain or practically demonstrate, okay, and practically demonstrate how to validate the manually created or auto-generated XPath expressions and CSS selectors using this ChroPath. Okay, all these three things I am going to practically show you right away. Okay, so guys, let me switch to the practical mode. So open this Chrome browser, guys, like this, and search for Google, search for ChroPath. Okay, simply search for ChroPath, guys. In the Google search results, you will get this first hyperlink, first result. It will look like ChroPath for Google Chrome and https://chrome.google.com ChroPath, some text will be there. Just click on that, guys. You will be taken to a Chrome web store, okay, Google Chrome web store, where you will find good number of extensions or add-ons, okay, where ChroPath is one of them. So if you have directly searched for ChroPath and went here, right, so you have been taken to the ChroPath page in this Chrome web store. Okay, ChroPath page in this Chrome web store. Now what you have to do here is you have to, okay, so this is for Chrome browser, guys, ChroPath for Chrome browser. As you can see this in the Chrome web store, now we simply need to click on add to Chrome button. When you click on add to Chrome button, this kind of pop-up will come where you need to select add extension button. After clicking on add extension, you see this ChroPath will get added to your Chrome browser. You see this Chrome ChroPath add-on extension got displayed here. Some icon of ChroPath got displayed here, and it clearly says that ChroPath has been added to Chrome. Okay, use this extension by clicking on this icon. Manager. This is like general stuff. Okay, now we have ChroPath added here, guys. Okay, go to any website. Now let's go to any website like omaya.blogspot.com, where we have good number of UI elements available on the web page, right? There are good number of UI elements for your practice purpose in this website. That's fine. Now first This is the icon that got added by ChroPath, right? When you have installed ChroPath add-on, this icon got added, right? Click on this icon, guys. Nothing. You will only get the information, guys. Okay, you will not get the ChroPath functionality by clicking on this icon. But when you click on this icon, okay, so like the developer page is coming where he is asking you to provide the review, and he has given some instructions for you to like how to use. Okay, how to use after adding ChroPath, restart Chrome browser. Okay, open DevTools panel by pressing F12, like that. Okay, click on inspect. You can do a lot of stuff, guys. Okay, so this is how he has given some information for you to help you on using how to use ChroPath. He has explained in this information slide. Okay, so fine. Now let me directly show you. Instead of me walking you through all these instructions step by step, what I will do is I'll directly show you how to get this ChroPath functionality in this Chrome browser. Okay, now the ChroPath has been added successfully, right? ChroPath has been installed and added successfully to the Chrome browser. This ChroPath functionality is now extending the Chrome browser functionality. By default, Chrome browser, okay, by default the Chrome browser doesn't have this ChroPath functionality, but since we have installed the ChroPath in our Chrome browser, since we have installed ChroPath add-on in our Chrome browser, now this ChroPath functionality is extending the Chrome default options. Chrome browser default options will also have the Chrome ChroPath options now. Okay, now what I will do here is right click somewhere on this page and select inspect option. So when you do that, okay, I have not selected any UI element, guys. Some blank area I selected and selected inspect option. When I did that, okay, or here I will say, let me inspect here. So generally when you do such kind of things, okay, you will get this Chrome developer options, guys, like this. Okay, Chrome developer options will be displayed. So this Chrome developer options, the Chrome developer options, as you can see, this elements tab is selected by default. If not selected, guys, okay, this elements tab will contain, under this elements tab we can see entire HTML code of this entire web page that is displayed on the top of this Chrome developer options. Okay, these are the Chrome developer options, and as you can see, this is a web page, and the HTML code of this entire web page got displayed under this element tab. By default, this element tab will be selected. If not, guys, you have to select it. Okay, when this elements tab is selected, okay, you will see some subtabs of this elements tab. Okay, you will see some subtabs of this elements tab, that is styles, computer, event listener, and so on, right? There are a few more options available. To see all the options, what you have to do is you have to drag this pen to the left side. Okay, this panel you need to drag to the left side. When you drag this panel to the left side, as you can see, the first subtab of this element is styles, then computer. Some different options are there, but you can see the last subtab, okay, that is nothing but ChroPath. Just click on this ChroPath, guys. The ChroPath, since you have installed ChroPath, okay, this functionality of ChroPath has been added to the Chrome developer options at the end of the subtabs of this elements tab. Okay, so by default you may not be able to see like this. The default UI will be like this. You have to drag it, guys, then only you will see the ChroPath available. Okay, you will not directly see that. So the default Chrome functionality got extended by this ChroPath functionality now, right? So we got this extra thing because we have installed it. We have manually installed the ChroPath add-on in the Chrome browser. That's why we got this option here. Now what you do is, after selecting this ChroPath, okay, now we know how to install ChroPath and how to find the ChroPath also, right? Now what you will do here is select this inspect option, guys. Select this inspect option, okay, and then click on this button too. Okay, when you select this inspect option, wherever you move, that will get highlighted. You see, so if I move to this get prompt, this is getting highlighted. Without this inspect option being selected, if you move the mouse, nothing is happening. But when you have the inspect option selected, if you move the mouse across different UI elements, you will see different options coming. When you hover itself, you will get these things. Okay, I didn't click, guys. I just hovered. After selecting this inspect option of the Google Chrome developer options, when I moved the mouse onto the button too, okay, just I hovered it, I didn't click it. You see, I'm seeing some kind of highlighting kind of things. Now click it, guys. Okay, click it means select it. In this case, after inspecting, you can only select. Okay, select the UI element. When I selected this UI element, immediately, as you can see, this ChroPath, okay, when the ChroPath is open and when you select this inspect option, then you hover the mouse. Okay, this all the steps you have to perform, guys. What I mean to say here is, if the ChroPath is not selected, it's like this. If it is there, it doesn't work. Okay, you have to move the panel to the left side, then select the ChroPath, then select the then leave it like this. Okay, leave the ChroPath in the open mode. Now you can see the ChroPath function. You have to see the ChroPath functionality. When the ChroPath functionality is visible, then select this inspect option. Then hover the mouse onto different UI elements, whatever the element you want, just go there, hover the mouse and select it. When you select that, guys, this ChroPath functionality will auto-generate the relative XPath expression, absolute XPath expression, and CSS selector, relative CSS selector. Like this, three things got auto-generated, guys. You see, using ChroPath, I have not written any manually. I didn't write any XPath expression, or manually I didn't write any absolute XPath expression, or manually I didn't write any relative CSS selector here. But since just because of this inspect and selecting this button, okay, the relative XPath expression, absolute XPath expression, and CSS relative CSS selector of this particular button got auto generated by this ChroPath functionality here. Okay, as now you can copy it, guys. For example, let's find out whether this is really locating or not. Copy this. Okay, this is a copy option, guys. So this whatever the relative XPath expression that got copied will be copied here. Okay, copy this. Let me type something, remove this. Okay, just copy this. Okay, just copy this, select this relative XPath expression, and whatever the this relative XPath that you copied, paste it here. Okay, and press enter. Okay, it's locating button ID like this. Okay, this XPath expression, for example, if I select /P or something, some other thing will be located, right? Now if I paste whatever the auto-generated relative XPath expression of this button, if I paste and press enter, you see the button is getting located, right? This button is getting located, guys, using this auto-generated relative XPath expression of this ChroPath. We are able to locate the inspected button. Okay, so now I will select the absolute XPath expression, which got even the absolute XPath expression also got auto-generated, right? Let me copy this, okay, and paste it here and press enter. You see, this button is getting located using this absolute XPath expression. And also there was some CSS selector also. Copy the CSS selector, paste it here, enter. You see, one element is matching, that is nothing but this button. So like this, guys, ChroPath will auto generate the absolute XPath expressions, relative XPath expressions, and relative CSS selectors for us, okay, on inspecting. You can also do a different way, guys. Like for example, you want to auto generate the, let's say you want, till now you have auto generated the for these things, right, using ChroPath. Now let's auto generate for this text box field. Okay, so instead of selecting inspect and coming here, what you can do is, first thing you have to make sure is that ChroPath is in visible mode like this. Okay, then second thing here is, right click inside this text box field and select this inspect option. Instead of inspecting from here, you can also inspect from here. When you inspect, guys, so let this selector option, so that you can see all the auto generated, otherwise you will see only that filtered things. Okay, when you inspect this, as you can see, for this particular text box field, relative XPath expression, absolute XPath expression, and relative CSS selector got here absolute CSS, it looks like. Okay, right? Sometimes relative will be generated, sometimes absolute CSS selector will be located. It depends. Okay, so now the second way also, we got some auto generated XPath expressions and CSS selectors using this ChroPath for the inspected elements. Now, guys, so we can validate them also. Okay, how to validate this? Copy this, paste it here. This is an XPath expression. Select this relative XPath and press enter, guys. Okay, it is locating. Okay, it's locating. So like that, guys, if you remove this and enter, it will not happen, and press enter, you see it's locating. Okay, this relative XPath expression is locating this text box field. Okay, that's how we can validate the auto-generated the XPath expressions and CSS selectors. Okay, we can validate the auto-generated XPath expressions and CSS selectors from the ChroPath itself like this. Now what we can do here is, now what I will do is, I will manually create some XPath expressions, okay, and try to validate here. For that, what I will do here is, I'll keep this ChroPath in hidden mode. Okay, I don't want to keep that in visible mode. Now it's in hidden mode. So basically, I will use some element here. Okay, let's say I want to locate this click to get alert. Okay, button. Right click inspect it. So its ChroPath is still on, guys. Okay, I thought it's not on. Let me turn it off otherwise. Okay, I am turning it off, so it will not auto generate now. And turn it off. So let me do one thing. Let me refresh it so that I will get fresh kind of instance. Right click inspect and elements tab, then slide it this side, ChroPath. I will turn it off. Initially only I am turning it off, guys. Okay, so nothing is there. Now guys, what I will do when this ChroPath option is turned off, I am trying to manually create some XPath expression for this button. Right click on this button and select inspect option. So the HTML code, for this particular button got highlighted here. You see, this is the HTML code of this button. So using this button, what I am going to do is I am going to create some XPath expression here. So input tag, so double slash input I will say. Then I can filter this UI element by adding this attribute name and value, that is ID attribute name and value, that is at the rate ID is equal to what is the value, alert one, alert one. Okay, now we got this. I manually created, guys. I didn't auto generate this XPath expression. I manually created with my own hands then XPath expression which can locate this button, right? So now select, now enable this ChroPath and select this relative XPath. Whatever the XPath expression I manually created, I pasted here. Okay, this is the XPath expression I manually created, guys. And now press enter. You see the manual, it's validating the manually created XPath expression and locating the ULMN. Okay, it shows me that one ULMN is matching, that is this click to get alert is matching. Similar way, I can select this CSS selector and I can create some CSS selector for locating this button also. This is the HTML code of this button, guys. So I will say input ID is equal to, what is that value? Alert one, okay. This is a CSS selector. I am manually creating the CSS selector and pressing enter. You see, it got located. Okay. Manually, whatever the manually created CSS selectors or XPath expressions, you can see whether they are really working and locating the required elements from the ChroPath itself, guys. Okay. That's how you have to use ChroPath that's how you can install ChroPath and use ChroPath for auto generating the XPath expressions and CSS selector. And finally, you can also manually create the XPath expressions and the CSS selectors and validate those things with the help of the ChroPath itself. Okay, so this is how we have to use ChroPath, guys. ChroPath is very good alternative when you use in Chrome browser. Okay, this is the best alternative for the deprecated FireBug and FirePath add-ons, which are no more available now. Fine, let me switch to the presentation mode, guys. So guys, I have practically showed you how to install ChroPath in Chrome browser, how to auto-generate the XPath expressions and CSS selectors using ChroPath in Chrome browser, and finally I have also manually created some XPath expressions and CSS selectors for a UI element on the web page, and showed you how to validate those expressions and selectors using ChroPath in Chrome browser, right? I covered everything in a practical way. So here ends this current video session, guys. In the next video session, I'll explain installing and using ChroPath in the next possible browser, that is Firefox browser. Okay, so in this current video session, I explained how to install and use ChroPath in Chrome browser. But few people may also want to install and use in ChroPath in Firefox browser due to XYZ reasons. Okay, for that reason, the next video session, I'm going to cover the installation and using ChroPath in next browser, that is Firefox browser. So that's it for this session, guys. See you in the next session. Thank you. Bye.